Welcome back, everybody. I go by the name Chris B, the drummer boy, and today we want to make one of those beats that you have in your archive and you don't want nobody to listen to it. I've had this beat since 2016, you know, and when one of those beats that you don't play for nobody, I just use it to, like, you know, satisfy myself that, okay, it's like, I don't know how to explain it. Like when you're addicted to something and you one of those beats that you want to keep, that, yo, when I'm dead, you bury this beat with me. So, apparently, Techno heard it that night and we were on some level. So he did it. I was just like, yeah, let's do it. And he did it and it came out amazing. This is Choco by Techno. Produced by Chris B, the drummer boy. Me. So yeah, straight up, the first thing I did on this beat, funny enough, the first and only idea I had in mind was this. So after I did Wee Wee Whoa, that's me singing, by the way. No extra package on it. Just direct the way you record it and process it the same way you process your vocals normally. So after that one, we enter, yeah, the drums. So, okay, let me mute this out so you can hear the drums. Wee Wee Whoa. If you need your headphones to know what's going on here, I don't know if you can hear the drums, but it's actually very simple. The kick. And that's the first thing we did. So after that bounce, then the comb bounce. Yeah, then extra shakers. Extra. If you're making Afrobeat and you have no shaker in them, you're making your beat not Afrobeat. So yeah. Oh, I love this. I should save it. Sorry. You know, when you are making reviews, you need to save some samples. So yeah, I love that one. Yeah, I love that one. So, yeah. Yeah, I love that one too. What? Okay, yeah, so we have that chikiba. We have that bounce for the that chikiba is actually me. One of those my sample packs. So yeah, after that we have this guy. Okay, now I've forgotten how I got the sound. Wait, let me think. Okay, let me just explain it. It's a lady's voice, and you put it into pitch shift. Pitch format, reverb, delay, and more reverb. More reverb. No compression, nothing. Just EQ. Cut the low, you know. Just your normal EQ. Just the way it sounds good. When it sounds good to you, just know you've done it right. So another thing, if you've seen my previous tutorial, if you've seen my previous tutorial, I explained something about using a conga as a synth. So yeah, I use the same thing here. So yeah, we have that, and we have. Has too many stuffs in it, man. Too many stuff in it, sorry. Too many. Okay, yeah, to the highlights. This guy. I used this guy. Like I told you, this guy is a sampler. It's a vocoder. You could use it for one of those stuff. So, yeah, I used it and I changed this guy.
Jump and la the way you wind your body for me. Jump and la the way you wind your body for me. Jump and la the way you wind your body for me. Jump.
That's me. So yeah, came out like this. So yeah, more shaker. So let's hear what that sounds like with the drums. Okay, yeah. So after that part, what's this guy called, Tef? The roll, yeah. The roll. So the intro sounds like this. Not everything, but yeah. So the first part of the song comes with I think this guy. I mean, if you can get this and make this right, I'm sure you can make any vibe right, you know. Like if you can get this, like those of you guys who are not from this part of the world, struggling with Afrobeat, if you could get this one right, you're good. So yeah, after that roll, that's a conga, by the way. Just look for a conga that has tonality in it, so you could just map it out, get the key, and you know, play from the key you want to play from once you know the root note. So after that guy, the next thing we did was that kalimba is also from this guy here. So. So yeah, you know, normally I want to add my pad to make it feel good. You know, that warm feel. And with the pad, it sounds like this. Okay, yeah, sounds like one of my creations. So this guy, I looped this guy. I bring the intro back because all we had to record with was just from the intro from the intro, like from here. Funny how so little things could sound like you have a whole lot of things. I have like barely 10 instruments here, you know. Like when I say 10, I mean like plus the drums one by one with the instruments, with the everything. Not more than 10. But it sounds like I have like the whole world in the beat, you know. So you should know how not to make your frequencies clash. I always say this: once you are clashing your frequency, you're gonna mess the whole song up. You know what I mean? Yeah. So here's the whole song from intro to this guy. Yeah, after this part, I just looped this part and it played from beginning to the end. Then yeah, the old school bass, the Nigerian old school dancehall music bass. Yeah, so that's like the real Konto vibe, typical Nigerian Konto vibe. That's pretty much everything. We looped here, the intro comes again, you know, just the way it sounds better to you, just chop and chop and chop. The beat was like 12 bar when I brought it to tech, and the whole song is 12 bar, and you can never know it's 12 bar because the way we change stuff and make it juicier, if there's any word like that. So yeah, thank you guys for joining me today. So hit the subscribe button, like, unlike, comment, hit me up, man. And you can follow me, I'm sure it's showing right now. So hit me up, let me know how it's going. Peace. No freestyle for you today. Peace.